Hey everyone, this is Stephanie from Fast Track to Health. I am a licensed acupuncturist and functional medicine practitioner here in Southern New Jersey. Today we're going to talk about my favorite mineral, magnesium. So I'm sure you've all heard of magnesium, but you may not really know how important magnesium is. Well, magnesium is one of the main electrolytes in our body, and it's involved in over 300 different processes in the body. So let's start with some signs of deficiency. So if you're suffering from any of the following things, it may be as simple as a magnesium deficiency. So the first thing is headaches. There's a very high association with any type of headache and magnesium deficiency, whether it's migraines, tension headaches, you could simply have a magnesium deficiency. Next is muscle cramps. If you're laying in bed at night and you start getting the muscle cramps in your calves especially, it could be a mineral deficiency. Most likely it's magnesium. It could also be partially from potassium deficiency, but magnesium deficiency is also very likely. So magnesium is also very important for your bones. It works in conjunction with calcium to make sure that your bones are strong. So if you do have bone density issues, it could be magnesium deficiency. Next is blood sugar. If you have any type of blood sugar issues or diabetes, again, you could be suffering from a magnesium deficiency. Okay, another important one is high blood pressure. High blood pressure has a lot to do with electrolytes being in balance. So make sure you're getting enough magnesium and also potassium and calcium for high blood pressure as well. Now, magnesium is a very relaxing mineral. It's the opposite of calcium. Calcium constricts and magnesium relaxes. So insomnia, so if you're not sleeping well, that could also be a magnesium deficiency. So if you take magnesium before bed, that can really help you sleep better. If you're suffering from any type of anxiety disorder, again, could be partially related to magnesium deficiency. Muscle pain, fibromyalgia, again, magnesium deficiency. It helps soothe and relax muscles. So consider that. And then constipation, if your bowels are not moving very well and are very slow, again, it could be magnesium deficiency. So now it's very difficult to get all the magnesium that you need from food. And the majority of people are magnesium deficient in this country. They estimate about 80% of people are deficient. So you can Google like a huge list of foods that are high in magnesium. Avocado would be one of the higher ones on that list. You could try to get it from your food, but it's probably going to be better if you do also take a magnesium supplement. So now some forms of magnesium are better than others. So you want to look out for good forms of magnesium, such as magnesium glycinate, citrate, malate. These are good forms. Magnesium oxide is one of the more common ones that you'll see on many cheaper brands of vitamins. They're going to be more like a laxative. So unless you're looking just to move your bowels with the magnesium, this one's not going to be as well absorbed as the other types. In my clinic, I use a formula that has a combination of three forms of magnesium, and it's very well absorbed, and my patients love it. So anyway, I hope this information was useful, and please share this with anyone that's more interested in learning about magnesium. I thank you for listening, and I will see you in the next video. Take care.